typical high tunnel is big enough to walk in. That's why they call them high tunnels and not low tunnels. They are covered with something that lets sunlight in, and they're typically used to grow crops.
It's a greenhouse structure that's not heated actively. It's passive heating through solar radiation.
A typical structure would, like the one you see behind me, have bows spaced anywhere from 4 to 6 feet apart and then be covered with film plastic material that lets the sunlight in.
The difference between a hot tunnel and a greenhouse is simply the heating, or the lack thereof. In a true greenhouse, you have active heating, whether it be a fuel source like propane or wood.
Typically used to extend the growing season in the spring or the fall and into the winter, so you can get a little longer cropping season. Then there are all various types of sizes. They can be different lengths. They can be made out of different materials, and then they can have different ventilation systems. It's in the end walls. You can have some have vents in the roof, so there are different venting mechanisms.
So my thought is that the crop has to be able to pay its rent. It's going to be living within a square foot, give or take a few square feet, and if it's not giving you the output that you need to maintain the operation of that facility, then it's a problem.
People who've had success seemingly with strawberries and with raspberries, some of the brambles, they seem to be having success.
Bell peppers, tomatoes, herbs, lettuce, edible flowers.
In terms of cool season crops, people are growing things like spinach, lettuce, kale, some of the root crops.
Some of the advantages for high tunnels, again, it comes back to a market window. It allows you to plant maybe even up to a month or 2 months earlier than you normally would be able to plant in the field. Again, if you plant a month or 2 months earlier than you normally would in the field, that means you have tomatoes ready or crops ready, available before anybody else would when they're growing in the field, so prices generally will be high.
So some of the disadvantages are that managing the environment is important, and it can take time, and it can be a daily necessity.
You have to have a good understanding of what the climate's like, how you're going to manage those crops. Generally speaking, if you're growing tomatoes and bell peppers and cucumbers, if you want to try to maximize the space, meaning the whole volume of the structure, in my opinion, growing trellising vegetable crops is something of interest. My advisor once told me that there's no money in growing vegetables, there's only money in selling vegetables. So unless you have a market already established or some sort of idea of where you want to take your product, I think you need to slow down a bit and focus on that first. And once the market's been developed, or you've at least identify a viable market, then you can start moving forward with the additional processes